In this video, we'll explore the latest features introduced in Feather. Many features have been updated. Now you can set up lighting and shadows in Feather and apply various effects. You can also save 3D guides and draw smooth lines with pen pressure. With the Liquify tool, you can edit and adjust your work easily, as if it flows like water. If you're new to Feather, we recommend starting with the basic tutorial. All right, let's begin with rendering. In rendering, you can set up lighting and create shadows as you want. Start by tapping the cube-shaped icon in the stage panel to switch between the app. At first, you won't see any change yet. For curves to respond to render mode, materials must be set. First, select the curves you'd like to shape. Open the color panel and you'll see some new options. Select the second one, which makes volumes and shadows. Now turn on the render mode again, and you'll see shadows appear on your building. To adjust shadow direction, go to the Environment tab and select Lighting. Here you can control the direction, color, and intensity of the light. Tapping this icon aligns the light with your current view, which is very useful when quickly finding the position you want. You can also toggle ground shadows or switch shading styles. For example, tune shading reduces gradients significantly, which works well with certain art styles. In the color panel, you'll find the pattern tab. These procedurally generated patterns are ideal for adding textures or hatch that is hard to express by just selecting. Let's try applying a pattern to the roof. In the group tab, press and hold the group to select it. Then go to the pattern tab and try the last one. Adjust the sliders to control the pattern's density, angle, and contrast. Take some time to explore other patterns and use them to enhance your designs. Now let's have a look at the option on the right. This material is used for expressing light. Select the lighting group and switch it to the third material.
You won't see any changes yet.
Go to the Environment tab and tap the light bulb icon below. Adjust the slider to control the light's intensity. Now let's take a look at the last one, called Cutout. Before applying this material, let me introduce a useful feature in the new Feather. In the Group tab, press and hold the eye icon to isolate the selected group, allowing you to view it independently. Press and hold again or tap any eye to exit the isolation mode. It's especially helpful when you're treating so many groups. Let's go back to select the windows and apply the cutout. The cutout makes the curves follow the background. If you add an image to the background, it'll display that image within the cutout. This is effective when using textures or photos as backgrounds. We can now apply some rendering effects in the Environment tab, including the glow effect. Let's start by exploring the depth of field. To view the effect more clearly, switch to perspective mode by double-tapping with three fingers. DOF is a special effect that blurs distant areas based on the selected focus point. In the Control tab, Ensure that Pin Orbit Point is enabled. Then press and hold the area you want to focus on. The effects below are grain and pixelation. Grain adds a noise effect to your work. While pixelation converts your drawing into pixel art. This one works particularly well for character or environment artworks. Here is a simple example how this effect can be used. We're excited to see more fun creations with these rendering effects. All right, let's move on to the 3D guides, one of the most essential features in Feather. When you first open Feather, the first thing you'll create isn't a line, it's a 3D guide. Now, you can save these guides. Here's how. First, draw your guide. Hold the close button at the bottom and drag it up. You'll see the X in the middle rotate, making a plus. You can add another guide by just tapping the draw icon and draw the guide as you did before. You can manage saved guides in the Resources tab, where you can toggle them on and off. A cube with a filled top side means that you can draw on it. Tap the icon to make the guide visible but inactive for drawing, and tap once more to hide it completely. For more details on using the Resources tab, watch part 3 of the basic tutorial. Like saving a 3D guide, you can now easily create guides from general shapes. To choose a shape as a 3D guide, tap the sphere icon next to Loft. Let's try selecting the cube. Adjust its position or scale using the joystick and change the segments with the slider. Press Done to create the guide, and save it in the same way if you'd like. All guides are managed in the Resources tab. This time, I'll select them all and delete. Saving guides you might use again and using primitive shapes can save a lot of time. Plus, these guides even respond to pixelation. Maybe that'll come in handy someday. In the new Feather, we can use pen pressure while drawing. Toggle the icon here to turn on the option. Each brush will respond in its own way, adjusting thickness, opacity, or even color based on pressure. We're still exploring how pressure sensitivity should work with 3D brushes, so feel free to share your thoughts. The last feature to introduce is the Liquify. With this tool, you can easily refine your drawings. To use the Liquify tool, start by selecting the curves you want to adjust. Once you've chosen a curve or group, the Liquify option will appear at the bottom. The Brush tab on the left will switch to the Liquify tab. Now try pushing the curves with your pen to see them adjust in real time. Within the Liquify tab, you'll find three sliders to control size, range, and strength. You can also change the Liquify type. The most basic option pushes the drawing as if you're pressing with your finger. The Pinch tool pulls curves inward, while the Comb tool spreads them out, which is useful when creating smooth and clean lines. You can compare your results by holding the button in the center. Once you're satisfied, tap the checkbox to confirm. These are the main features to introduce, though there are more big and small updates, such as various overlay interfaces for sequences, the keypad for hex code input, and the amazing time-lapse export option. We'll dive into these in more detail in the next tutorial. So, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.